Hey there, Widgetarians. My name's Emmett Baber, and today we're going to talk about big data and information brokers and what they do and what those words mean. Big data is not the cloud. So big data refers to not just having a large amount of storage space, but actually having enough to store everything that takes place that they can monitor. Then, at a later point in time, sifting through that data. So let's say you have a Facebook profile, and you have a Twitter account, and you have a Pinterest board, and you have an Instagram, and a, well, not a Snapchat, because Snapchat's more of a message. Also lets you make posts, and you have a live journal, and you have, so across all of these different profiles, people can gather all of the information that's available publicly, and match it to see if there are any other profiles that share a majority of the same contact information. And then they can presume that that LiveJournal account belongs with that Facebook account, and that Twitter feed belongs with that LiveJournal, so they know that that is one, basically one person that made all those different disparate services. And then they can see how you use Facebook, and how you use Twitter, and how you use LiveJournal. And if they're lucky, they can match that to somewhere where you spend money, like eBay or Amazon.com. And those also track what you buy and record that information, because they have to. As I'm sure you've noticed, a lot of the internet runs on advertising still. That information of your tendencies and what you like to spend money on, that information is very valuable to the kind of people that make advertisements and the kind of people who try to line up those advertisements with their target demographics. A demographic is a group of people with a certain characteristic, usually age or gender. Now that's what one of the things that big data means to me. One of the things that big data means to other people is the fact that the government has started logging huge amounts of internet activity. And by huge, I mean like exobytes of data. Hey, I actually got that right. Okay, so it goes kilo, kilobyte, megabyte, gigabyte, terabyte, petabyte, exabyte. And the government has started storing all of our online, a lot of online interactions in these giant data centers that hold literal exabytes of data. It's just a huge amount. Even if it's encrypted, even if it's garbled and you need a specific key to get at that information, they can still hold on to it for a really long time until it becomes very easy to break that encryption, or that they can go through it to find more evidence for a seemingly menial case. So if they want someone to go to jail, they can go through this large block of data and dig up some other stuff to add to the case, even though it might not be relevant. How do you feel about big data? People are keeping tabs on you. Is privacy really a thing anymore? Do you care? Leave your comments in the doobly-doo. Click the button to stick around, and as always, stay curious.